First thing I did after the draft, actually, you know, a lot of people don't see it, but you have a lot of media after, a lot of media responsibility. And me and Sam Darnold were two of the higher picks, and we were two of the last people to leave, obviously being in New York and the media there and a high demand for that. And the first person I texted, I really wasn't texting anyone. I was so, like, in awe and shock still, and, like, it didn't hit me at all. But it was just it was an unbelievable moment and an unbelievable experience with the draft. The biggest change since I've been drafted, I won't say there's been a lot of changes. You know, it's the same thing. For me, I'll just say that being a dad, you know, having a little daughter, definitely that's a big change for me. And you know, people noticing you a little bit more, recognizing your face, and not just recognizing your jersey number and your name, recognizing your face. And those are really the two things I would say that changed to me. Not just from only my new teammate, just best advice I've gotten in my life and just leading up to this moment right now in the NFL would be stay who you are. Be who you are. Stay true to yourself. You're here for a reason. You got here for a reason. Stay true to yourself. Work your butt off. Continue to obviously grow and expand in other areas of your life, but stay true to you are, and everything else will take care of itself.
What can you remember about the moment you were drafted?
Hearing seeing the phone ring, and seeing the New Jersey and the number, and just picking it up and be able to talk to them, and you know, hearing that, you know, we're going to pick you with this pick, and you know, obviously it's not a dream to make it to the draft, the dream is to be elite and be able to, you know, have a long successful career in the NFL, but to get to that point, you got to have that draft, you have to have that moment, and that moment is something that you'll never forget. What team am I looking forward to play? I think, you know, obviously anyone in NFC East, they have so many great backs, and I'm a big fan of the position. And the NFL East, you look at the Eagles and you look at that core group of backs with Corey Clement and so on and so on. And you look at the NFC, you look at the Redskins with Darius Geis, and then the Cowboys, you got Zeke Elliott. Those are great backs. So I definitely look forward to playing against those guys and watching them perform. Hopefully that week or that game, they don't have too much success. But definitely looking forward to playing a future team, one of my ex-teammates, Marcus Allen. Definitely, you know, me and him, we've been boys throughout my whole college career, and we have a great relationship, and I respect his game, and that's someone I look forward to playing from Penn State. The weirdest thing I saw, like any skin contact, like if it's like a hand or whatever, that's like the weirdest thing you have to sign, in my opinion.
What is your game day meal?
Game day meal. You know, I don't eat a lot on game day. I try to eat just enough. One game I ate too much, and it was a hot game. My stomach just was not agreeing with me. But if I'm going to go, probably chicken, potatoes, you know, that's like what we were fed at Penn State.
Okay. Do you have any pregame traditions or rituals?
No. I'm not very big into stuff like that, you know. I just go with the flow every single day. I tape my wrists. I pray before games. Those are only, like, things I really can think of on the spot right now that I consistently do.
Okay. Do you have a current, like, playlist or hype song?
No, I don't. But if I have to, I go in between a little bit of Drake, a little bit of Meek Mill, A Boogie, J. Cole, Cardi B. I love Cardi B, actually, her music. So that's where I like stay with.
And then what, if you could play a sport besides football, what would you play?
Basketball. Definitely basketball. If I was 6'6 or 6'5, definitely would have took a different route. But I was not blessed with height at all. I'm short and stubby. So definitely a basketball. Basketball would be a great sport to play. No, I suck at a lot of things. I'm joking. Hidden talent. No. Besides football, I really don't have much. That's kind of sad to say. But I can't sing whatsoever. I have rhythm. I could dance a little bit, but just I'm not good in dancing in front of other people. I get shy, but no really hidden talents.